Hey guys, my name is Sevneray and welcome back to Subnautica. Now, a huge update just released, like, I don't know, today, yesterday, sometime, very recently, and I played through it a little bit, and there's a ton of new stuff. Precursor update, there's a bunch of stuff. So what I'm gonna do, I'm actually gonna start a new game, but what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna bring it to a freedom level, because, like, we don't really care about making sure that I'm not dehydrated or up to fooded or whatever. I just wanna, you know, play and explore this game. I'll play some survival on my own, but for now, for the channel, I feel like I'm just gonna play some freedom game because I really want to, and that way we can just concentrate on like showing off the stuff in the game and not really worrying about surviving. So like, don't take it as like too much of a cop-out, I guess. It's gonna be tons of fun. They actually fixed an issue that I was having, I think a lot of people were having, and that was that early game is like kind of slow. Like, once you've gotten over the wow factor of the whole thing, it's like, now what? Because it's really hard to find things, find more blueprints and stuff, and they really fixed that. I think they've scattered a lot more blueprints in places, and it's more easy to tell what they are. And there's a few more other, like, quality of life updates, too. Like, now it'll show you an icon of things you can scan, which is perfect for me, because as we all know, I fucking love scanning things. And it'll also show you when you have a new signal back at your base. And I think I screwed up in my last game by building a second, like, signal generator or signal receiver in my other base. So this is gonna take its sweet time loading, apparently. So I'm not gonna do that again. I'm only going to return to the life pod for the base, or the, for the signals, so that I don't worry about accidentally screwing something up in case there's like a bug in the code there. I didn't submit it, but for all I know, it could have been, because there was that last signal I got was just sort of like an error, or it didn't return anything. So I think I screwed that up, and I actually played through this one enough to get another, like a third or fourth signal or whatever. And it's interesting. I'm excited to share this stuff with you if it'll ever decide it maybe wants to load. Oh, also one more new thing I think they implemented. I don't know if it's just for not survival mode, whatever mode I chose, but they also changed when the Aurora explodes. I don't know if that's across all the game modes or just against the one I've played, because I haven't tried it again with the full survival mode, so we'll see, I suppose, if this ever decides it's gonna load. Oh, I'm hearing things. I sure am hearing things. What do we got? Awesome. Oh, here we go. That's weird. You've already got sounds from the ocean going on, even though this is playing. Uh-oh. Boom. So this intro sequence is about the same thing. Ooh, the ship explodes just in time. Shit starts flying around, some smacks you in the face. All that good stuff. Same old. Oh, there it goes. That was clearly well secured. And that was also clearly well secured. And fuck! There we go. Right above the eye, too. If you look at that corner of the thing, catches you right above the eyebrow. What? Oh, interesting. Maybe. Let me see. I'm curious. Oh, God. We are staggering about the place. Okay. So this is different, then. I believe this is different. Whoa, excellent. That's new. Also, I stepped in the fire because I'm an idiot. Okay, that was fun. Can I get out of here yet? Maybe. Oh, here we go. Oh, PDF, okay. Or PDA. So yeah, I guess it was a glitch in my old game, apparently. Because it actually started, the Aurora had immediately exploded, like, while I was trying to figure out how to pick up the, fire extinguisher. The Aurora was busy exploding, so I guess that was just a glitch of my previous game. Yes, I know. I know things. I know this. Thank you. Thank you, friendo. What's with the excellent up there? That's kind of new. I'm going to put this away. Yes, thank you. I'm going to put that away. I'm going to grab... Is there anything in here yet? I guess not. Okay, let's get out of here, shall we? Oh, it's daytime. Interesting. It was nighttime before. So I think this game's programming gets a little confused. T plus 3 hours since Planetfall, life pod hall secure, communications offline. Alright, so the first little bits of this are, pretty much the same. Wow, look at that kelp. Whoa, look at that kelp field. Yeah, I told you guys, this game is, randomly generated. Or some of it is sort of randomly generated. It is lagging hard is what it's doing. So I'm going to go, I'm going to go about doing the standard base building and collecting things. And I will get back to you guys when there is some new and interesting shit to report on. So I will see you guys in a bit. Oh shit. I will see you guys in a bit once I have successfully, once I have successfully, gotten myself closer back to where we were before. Oh, check it out. There's something down here already. Ooh, I don't know what that is, but I bet we can scan it. Ooh, good. So there's something to be scanned. So there's, like, things that don't look like debris, scattered around. Can I grab this first? Yes, good. Okay. Ooh, gosh. So those are things we're going to be looking out for. Things that look like broken pieces of shit. And that is going to get us started much more quickly on, like, the things we need to carry on and survive better. Also, one really nice thing they got rid of was, the old creep vine stuff. So I don't know if that's just because I'm not in full survival mode or not, but they seem to have gotten rid of the old creep vine thing for me, so like it doesn't like degrade immediately, which is nice. Alright, I finally got a scanner, and check it out, look in the lower right hand corner. If I approach one of these guys, boom, that little thing comes up showing that I can scan him, which is super neat. It's not obviously useful for these guys, but I'll show you guys later how it's extremely useful for other stuff like this. I can scan this to let it to get more information on it, and you guys will see how it will help me identify what other things. Oh, I need you! Oh gosh, please tell me I got the crash fish powder. Yes, good. That was hard to get. Wonderful. All right, things are coming together. Good. We have almost got all of our tools back. I'm short like two tools. I need the repair kit, which I think I'm gonna get now maybe. I also need the habitat builder. Oh yeah, I've got everything for the repair tool. Wonderful. I want to do the repair tool. Let's see. This one. Perfect. Good. And then we can start everything back up again. And then we'll start getting those signals, those sweet, sweet signals. We can start talking about the new and improved features that this game has. Hooray! No, I want that to be number 4, actually. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, perfect. There we go. Let's weld all this good shit up. Turn it on! Come on. Good, okay. And also, this needs heals. Perfect. And then we'll get our automated bounce back. Mm-hmm. Yup, same old. Yeah, I know. I don't want to move in case I'm going to screw it up. But now we'll start getting signals again, and the signals finally have a lot more interesting stuff happening. It's the same old signals you expected, but like there's more things around them, more scannable objects. And now that we have a scanning tool, let's go find that. Where was that little tiny wreckage site? I saw it a little earlier. Gosh dang diddly, I have no idea where it is. I think it was somewhere near the kelp fields. Please don't shit on me. Oh gosh. See, check that out. In the right-hand side of the screen there's a new signal already. So there we go. Perfect. Kind of stumbled across. Oh, here's another thing that's cool. If you beeline for the surface, you can breach, like, super far out of the water now. Like, you can really see it if you're looking down. Boom, you can kind of jump out of the water. And also, our character's head stays above the water now. Oops. Stays above the water now, which is super nice. I can, like, look at things without, like, drowning in myself, which is super cool. There's some salvage there. All right, I'll get back to you guys when I have found this thing that I am looking for. And I'm pretty sure it's somewhere around here. Oh, hey, wait, Oh, there it is. Yes, cool. There it is. It was actually straight over here. So now you can see this was what we've had before. But now if we look in some of these containers, they might actually contain some interesting stuff. Yeah. No, like this. This I can scan. Good. There's a lab counter. Remember we found that, like, table in the Aurora at the end of the last episode or whatever that was? There we go. So now we've got that. We can look inside these for more things. I think there's one or two other things around here, maybe? Let me see. Oh, God, is there not going to be anything in here? After I got so excited to show it to you all. Really? Oh, that would suck. This one isn't even open. Let me see. Anything? Oh, come on. There's, like, stuff in these. I promise there's stuff in these. We'll just have to find the other one. The Lafette had some around it. And of course, this is all, like, randomly generated, so I'm not sure when anything is near me or not. Some of the stuff in my other game, it was, like, all right here, and I kind of, like, stumbled across it, and it was kind of awesome. So I will show you guys, look like a frog. I will show you guys when I have finished my, gaining the rest of my shit. I still need a habitat builder so I can start another base by the Aurora. Oh, here we go. Oh, God, you can't even see it. That sucks. There's a thing in here. Can I get close enough to see it? No, there's a thing in here. So here's a cargo thing, but it's, of course, it's covered in weed, so you can't see it. But yeah, we have to look out for open cargo boxes like that to find pieces of things to scan. Also, I have no idea where that one thing that was, like, at the bottom of one of these ravines was. I should probably take a look at my oxygen first. And the Aurora is going to explode soon. I want to make sure I can see that. Oh, hey, here's some stuff down here. I bet there's going to be something in this. I bet there is. They wouldn't just put that there for no reason. And there is a... Yeah, there's a thing in there. Now you can see it. So there's a sea glide fragment. That's the other part. There's a lot of these. Good. So now I've got a sea glide. So I've got to look for shit that looks kind of like salvage, but clearly isn't. So that's the sort of stuff I've got to look for. Like, that's, you know, that's salvage. Oh, let's scan the creep mine too. Yeah, so that's the sort of stuff we have to look out for. And some of it's implement, most of it's implemented. Some of it is not implemented, which is sort of funny. This is just floating in space right here. Excellent. And I'm gonna find the, I wanna watch it. I wanna watch it. Come on. Where are you, Aurora? There it is. And now we can actually watch it from here. There we go. Whoa, that was not burning that much before. Wow, that is burning a lot. Six, five. Here we go. Uh-oh. Three. Uh-oh. Whoa. That is... Oh, God. Whoa. That is always pretty. Okay, now I've got to go back to my ship and craft myself a suit, a radiation suit, so I can, you know, not die from that. I realize the signal thing is gone. I guess it goes away after a while once you've sort of realized... It's still there once you sort of realize that it's a thing, so it doesn't stay around with you forever. Okay, let's talk to you. Yes, please. Altera crew, life pod 4. We've touched down too close to the crash site and radiation levels are too high to disembark. Oh, I got the sea glide now. Excellent. I want equipment. Fiber mesh and lead. I have one of those. Okay. So there's my other lead. Whoops. And there's two fiber meshes. Perfect. Okay. Hey, new message. Yes, please. Is it the LaFette? Yeah, that's LaFette. Okay, cool. So now that we have most of the things, we don't really need a base builder yet. I'm not going to deal with that immediately. First, I want to show you guys some of the newer stuff that was implemented. So I want to head over to Life Pod 4. We need... Oh, that's it. Okay, so I've almost got the habitat builder. So we've almost got everything. That's fine. I'm going to hang out over here. Oh, also, this is nice. They fixed Life Pod 4 so that the signal is actually coming from the Life Pod and it's not chilling below it. Which is really nice, because remember, it was like... It took me a while to notice that the Life Pod was above it, because the signal was down on the ground below. So, yeah, I'm happy that's a thing that happened. I can't wait to show you guys so much more about this game. It's so exciting. There's this big mist over there that I was told houses something very, very exciting, and I've never noticed it before. And you guys are going to be excited too, so we're going to get to that in this episode. I'm sure this is going to be a pretty big episode anyway, because I'm going to cover everything I covered before and then some. Actually, you know what? I don't know if we'll get to it in this episode, because, like, I know what it is, but I kind of want to go through it in sequence, which requires me to get through the Aurora first, which requires me to get a laser cutter, which I haven't gotten yet. So I'll have to look through and find the laser cutter to get through the Aurora. And then we will be able to get over to that thing, so probably in the next episode. That was a horrifying noise. I think that was a Reaper Leviathan. Super good. I'm so glad those are around here. Oh, the sunset's actually super nice. That was super neat. Oh, it is dark out. It is dark out. So there's Life Pod 4. It is actually emanating from the Life Pod itself. There we go. There's the Life Pod. And it's been breached. Of course, it's been breached. You knew it was breached. Oh, we can get a bonus water, even though we don't need it because we're not playing in that game mode. And the rest of this is just straight up screwed. But now down here, we're obviously by the Aurora. And there's like a bunch more. I think they did away with the little helper boxes. And instead they just have all these cargoes everywhere. So like, this is a thing, they just haven't implemented it, but it's still like a square thing. You can see it, it's just a square cube for now, but it's supposed to be a vehicle upgrade console fragment. So there's a whole bunch of fragments of blueprints around here. And this is where I'm happy that they sort of changed around the formula for what to do, for like what you can find around here, because there's like cargo boxes all over the place and they're full of things. Like, what is this? It's a propulsion cannon. Good, I need that. That's, I think that's one of the things I need to maneuver around the... Oh, there we go. We got it already. To maneuver around the Aurora. And there, I think there's a bunch of these too. Wait, there's another vehicle upgrade. There's another cube. The other one was like half sunk into the ground, so it wasn't actually a rectangle. It was a full-on cube. But now we have a vehicle modification station, which we can't use yet, because it doesn't have we don't have like a moon pool or whatever, which I think is what's required. Oh gosh. Oh, yep. Let's get back up to the surface, please. There we go. And then we'll come back down. I'm gonna bring a base out here. I'm gonna set up a base out here, probably off camera. Exactly the way I did before, and use this as like a new base of operations for stuff. And what's nice is that even if you find all the pieces of a set, it'll give you titanium for scanning it. I think we noticed that before, but since I've already got the vehicle upgrade console, it'll just give me titanium for it, so it's like free titanium, which is always neat, because, you know, titanium is always good, especially when you're base building. Oh, looks like they didn't fully do away with the supply chests. That's awesome. Good, because I kind of liked those. Hopefully it's a battery and not like water or anything. Oh, battery, or power cell, even better. I like those. Anything else in here? I think I saw something off to the left there. Nope, I guess not. Gosh, it is so... Oh, wait, yes. It is so dark. I don't need this water. I'm going to drop it off at my base. I'm probably going to drop it off underneath my base because I don't need it. And it's going to take up an inventory slot. Oh, power transmitter fragment. Yes, please. That's new. Oh, that was it. I just needed the one. Nice. I think that's about it for around here. What's this? Oh, it's another propulsion cannon fragment, I think. Sure looks like it. Whoops. Yeah. All right, let's head back home and we'll come back out here with base creation supplies and such. And then we shall carry on with... Oh, I also want to go to the Lafette. So we'll go back to the base, stop off there, go to the Lafette, find more of this, which is nice. Oh, yes, please. And dawn is breaking, which means I'll probably have to come back here during the day to find all the things I missed otherwise. Look how tiny my life pod is on the horizon there. Like, hey, it's my dot. There we go. That's my home. Computer chip. Yes, please. I think that's all I needed for the... Yes, the habitat builder. Wonderful. We've almost got everything. I think I need an advanced wiring kit. And a battery, okay. Advanced wiring kit battery. I think I have everything I need. You just need, like, I think maybe a couple golds? What do I need for the advanced wiring kit? Let's see. We need and a computer chip. Okay, so I don't have the stuff for that right now, so we'll hold off on the propulsion cannon for the moment. Let's gather base building materials. Bunch of fucking titanium. Wonderful. Hey, friendo, what do you need? Yes, please. From Aurora Life Pod 7, okay, so I haven't gotten there yet. Yeah, we'll do that in a minute. I need lead. Don't need it, but it's rare. Oh, there it is. Wait, is that it? Yes, that is it. Good. What are you? Movable vehicle bay fragment. Yes, I need that. Wonderful. I need that to start making, like, sea moths and shit. Good. Hopefully there's, like, more of them around here. Ugh, it's so dark. Is this a new... This is a new site. Okay. I think there's more things to scan. What is this? I don't know what that is. Looks like an unfazed... That's weird. It looked like a cargo thing that was not... What is all of this? Oh, I found a new tiny salvage port. Oh, hey, that looks like something scannable. What can I scan from it? Oh, another mobile vehicle bay. Yes, mobile vehicle bay. Good, I need one more. Trash cans. I suppose those can be useful. There we go. Here's a bunch more stuff. See, this is what I like. There's a lot more. It's like concentrated and it's obvious to find. And it's, pick up lab equipment. Okay. Can I pick up that other lab equipment? Is that what that is? I don't know what that was. I guess I'll just take it with me and I'll put it somewhere once I found a spot for it. All right. What else have we got? Oh, I can pick that up. I don't know what it is, but I can pick it up. Oh, yeah, let's get rid of the table coral. Another lab equipment. Okay. Yes, so we have that. We need two titaniums. We need six titaniums. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and two quarts in a glass. Two quarts in a glass. I have a million quartzes in one glass. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 4, 8, 12. How many did I say I needed? I don't remember. Probably more than this, though. Excuse me, can I please do the thing? I need 2, 4, 6, 8, 12. I need exactly that many. I'm going to grab a few more just in case. Because I'm probably also going to want a storage locker as well. Okay, that is going to be it. I'm going to go to... Oh, nice. Dawn is breaking and everything. I'm going to go over to Life Pod 4 and make a base underneath it. And that'll free up a ton of inventory and stuff. And it'll be good times. And then we will go to Life Pod 17 and also Life Pod 7. So I'll have to come back here. Actually, no, we're not going to come back here. I'm going to grab that other signal. Do I have it in my inventory? I sure do. Perfect. Whoa, that was cool. One of them just handed it off to the other, or they stole it. Probably they stole it because I'm sure they're assholes and he just stole it back. That is super neat. I love watching these things sort of interact with each other. They will often like take, like passing swipes at fish. Not actually eating them, just kind of taking, passing swipes at them. Oh God, he's coming back. Yeah, like that, just kind of take a passing swipe at something. Without actually, like there's no like eating animations. So. Oh, go away, sand sharks. I don't care. I'm gonna pass through some different biomes and shit, so... Oh, whoa, excuse me. I don't understand why these things go after me. Like, I understand why they go after me, but at the same time, I don't. Is this tiger plants? Can I scan this? What is this? Violet bow. Very nice. You can cut these and get, seeds from them and stuff. But I don't know what to use them for yet. So I'm not gonna deal with it right now. Oh, there's more of the, I forgot what they're called already. The giant floaty... shelf coral table lives things. I'm very good at English, can you tell? We're gonna put this reasonably underneath here. So here we go. Let's begin, shall we? Foundation. Build first. Whoops. I'm gonna build this foundation somewhat close to the edge for reasons that will become apparent eventually. So let's build this right here. Good. There we go. I'm gonna start with a, whoops, not that one. I'm gonna start with a little X component. And I'm actually gonna put the hatch on this outside. Oh good, there's a new thing already. A new signal way back at the base. Good. Okay, next thing is power. Yes, please. Probably even a second power if I can manage it. There we go. That was weird. Awesome, now let's go inside. Welcome aboard, Captain. Thank you. Okay,
power restored.
Yes.
All primary systems online.
Wonderful. Fabricator right there. Brilliant. Super brilliant. Not a communications relay, because I think that screwed me up before. A wall locker. Yes, please. Put that on over here, actually. There we go. Brilliant. Locker. Can I put the loop? Can I dump the lab equipment somewhere? I wonder if I can just drop it here. Maybe. Oh, I can. I can just kind of put it here. Oh, I want to have a table for it, actually. There we go. Put that there. And we'll put the other one, like, here. There we go. Okay, so they're just there for decoration. I don't really need them for any reason, but they'll chill there. They're not doing any harm to anyone. Now I have a ton of free space. Wonderful. Good things are happening. Okay, we have a base. We have a base. We have enough... Do we have enough to get a second? I'm gonna try to get a second. Oh, I messed everything up. Oh, there's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go, 5. I'm gonna put up another, I don't have enough titanium, but we have titanium all over the place here. There we go. Let's go scan this. I'm sure we can scan this for titanium. And then we will carry on. Yeah, this is definitely like titanium worthy. Boom, excellent, 2 titaniums. 2 titaniums, if you will. And then we will finish off this bad boy. Whoops, that's not it, that's it. Brilliant! Okay, now we have double the amount and it's slowly charging. Good things are happening. Now I want to go, let's see, we have enough space, we have enough everything. I would like to go, check out the Lafette. We never went down there. We'll go down there at some point too. That looks really interesting. Let's go check out the Lafette, which is way the hell over there. And actually, I'm also going to switch out my signals from coordinate 4. And let's hit up Life Pod 7 first, because that is much closer. And we'll go through the forest. Why the hell not? We'll go through the forest. We'll pick up some more titanium along the way. There we go. That'll be nice. Good. And let's just chill and see if we can. Oh, these are pretty. I wonder if they're dangerous. I don't know, but that looks like a scannable thing down there. I'm excited to see what it is. I really want a sea moth. I don't know. I haven't found any parts for that just yet. That's a creature egg. Okay. Scan you. Come here. Jelly ray. Dominated by plant life, picking up faint Altera technology signatures. So that means there's stuff buried in here. Can I scan any of this? Oh, I can scan the tree mushroom. Ooh. Excellent. So this is new stuff. Wonderful. Oh, this is super pretty. This is super pretty and I love it. Let's go up to the surface. Oh God. Oh God. We are down deep. Oh goodness. I hope we're gonna make it. Oh geez. Oh geez. Oh gosh. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Oh, I don't think I'm gonna make it. Oh my God. No. If I die here, this is gonna be, oh my God, I'm not even close. Oh my God. I actually died. Whoa. Let's save real quick just in case. Oh my God. Please don't tell me that's it. Oh no, what happened? I think I just get to go back. Okay, cool, I'm back here, wonderful. What did I lose? I don't think I lost anything. Excellent. So yeah, so if you die in the game, you actually don't die in real life, surprisingly. I lost my, okay, so I lost all the inventory I didn't secure. Hence the reason why you would secure, what the fuck is that? Hence the reason you would secure your inventory every time you, oh, it's a giant lithium crystal is what it is. I need to find out what to do with these. I bet you harvest them with really big mining equipment that I don't have yet. Do I have to rescan the ray? I'm curious about that. I wonder if I do. Anyway, so death is not permanent, which is nice. There is a mode in which death is permanent. Okay, so I don't have to rescan that. And also, I don't have to rescan that either. Good, that's finished. Wonderful. Good stuff is happening, guys. So death is not permanent. It just kind of sucks a little bit. Tree leech, what the hell are you? I mean, obviously you're a tree leech, but God, that's gross. Is there anything else scannable on these? I'm sure there is. So I gotta be really careful and frequently go back to the surface. And see what else is here. I gotta find stuff that's here. That's an egg. Okay, cool. God, these are so pretty. Look at them. They're so pretty from below. That is so nice. Oh, please tell me I'm gonna make it in time. It's gonna suck if I have to keep coming back, like, up tier. And I don't think I'm gonna make it in time again. I'm not gonna make it again in time. Wow, okay. So we're gonna have to craft a third, tank. Ugh. God damn it. Well, I was actually able to, scan something else here. Come on, I'm almost there. Didn't make it. Damn it, didn't make it. Alright, we'll keep going. This is why I need, the sea moth. Okay. What the hell are you? Whole fish that was just kind of pirouetting in space there. Okay, we have 135 oxygen left. Oh, what the hell was over here? This isn't loaded yet. You want to, oh, that was nice. That loaded very nice. Oh, geez, there's so much. There's so much, everybody. I want to find the faint traces of Altera technology, too. I've discovered that Altera is where we're from, right? Altera, Earth. I didn't really discover it, sort of figured it out. Altera is where we're from. So, like, the technology that's going to be present here is, like, you know, abandoned shit. Oh, this is so nice. Look at this whole section, even though it hasn't loaded over there yet. This is lovely. That looks like something. Okay, let's. We have enough to go down to it. I think it's just a creature egg. It sure looks like a creature egg, doesn't it? God damn it, there's creature eggs everywhere. Stop laying eggs, everybody. That's gross. Copulating in the water. What is that? It's a piece of a sea moth. Oh, yes. A piece of the sea moth. Yes, please. Oh, it's part of the Cyclops. Oh, even better. Oh, there's like pieces of the Cyclops I need. Wonderful, let's go straight up to the surface, because holy shit, because gosh, there is stuff down here. The Cyclops is amazing. If you guys have ever seen anyone else play it, the Cyclops is like the really big diving thing. It's like the size of a small city in comparison to everything we've built so far. You know what, yeah, let's hold off on this, because we clearly need the sea moth for this. And I think fragments of the sea moth are over at Life Pod 7 and 17, so we're gonna head over to those, which are actually just right over here. Oh, good, another signal. Wonderful. We'll head back to the Aurora, too. How much? I have plenty of space. I have lots of space, lots of stuff. Good things are happening. It's hard to tell if the sun is setting or if it's just getting dark because it's getting dark. I think it's a combination of both. There is some interesting shit down there. I want to know what it is. Whoa, there's lots of interesting shit down here. We'll deal with that later. Oh, those are table coral. I thought they were, tubes for some reason. Or whatever, there's shelf coral. Stay away from that thing down there, it's gonna shoot shit at me. Coral shell plate, yeah, okay. And there's the downed life pod 7, that sucks for them. I think that was the, no, the Lafette was the 17. I'm gonna grab the, oh, a compass. Oh, I have a compass now. Nice. Nice, nice. Okay, let's go straight up. Yes, I know. I think I'm gonna have to fix that somehow. I'm not super sure how. Probably with the fixing tool, I imagine. Please tell me. Because actually, I really need to get back somewhere and secure this, because I could lose that compass forever, I think. Brilliant. Okay. While that's doing its thing, I want to take a look at the voice log for, automated message distress signal from more life pod 7, coordinates attached. Okay, so that was just there. I think that's all there was to life pod 7. So I'm gonna leave that one for now. Maybe we'll come back to it some other time if we're ever in the neighborhood. But I'm gonna head over to the Lafette, life pod 17, which I think contains pieces of the sea glide. Or the sea moth. That is way the fuck over here. It's gonna take me a while to swim to that. I will see you guys in a bit. The Lafette is below us. Dawn is breaking. This giant orange ball is floating through the sky. Wonderful. Okay. Let's go down here. By the time we get down here, it should be like nice and bright out. And there should be a ton of stuff around here. I don't know where that glowing is. There should be a ton of stuff around here. We'll check that out in a second. Because we're near a gigantic chunk of the Aurora that went down. And there should be like a bunch of other stuff near it. What is that? Whoa. Can I repair that? That's nice. Can I touch it? It doesn't hurt. Can I repair it? Nope. Okay, that was worth trying. Oh, let's head straight to the life pod. Oh, this looks nice. I don't think I've been to this one yet. There's part of the sea moth right there. Boom. Good. I need that. I want this part of the sea moth. I think there's three parts to the sea moth. And then I'm going to try to get one of those as soon as I can. I still think I need the, oh, was that it? I think that was just it. That's cool. I haven't looked at any of these PDAs either to see if they've updated or anything. Wonderful. Now let's take a look around. That looks like another piece of the sea moth, but I'm not sure if it is. What is that? Is there something in there? A bioreactor. I don't know what it is, but I want it. Encyclopedia entry unlocked. These are encyclopedia entries, but does that mean that I can make them? Probably not yet. I'm gonna keep- oh god, excuse me, red whatever. I'm gonna keep looking around for more things I can scan and pick up and do things with. Battery charger. Yes, please. Oh gosh, I haven't saved in a while. Oh gosh. Cough, cough, choke, 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 choke. Awesome, let's take a look at these blueprints, shall we? Databank. Technical. Equipment. Propulsion cannon. Power. On planets where organic matter is plentiful but sunlight is not, a reliable bioreactor will frequently prove the most efficient power solution. May be installed in any multipurpose habitat room. I don't have a multipurpose room yet. Okay, vehicles, Cyclops, Sea Glide. Sea Glide's personal transportation device, don't have that one. Cyclops. Person 6. Recommended the captain drop a rota to decide who gets to sleep in the corridor each night. Emergency ballast. In the event of flooding and full power failure, this vehicle will sink. Extensive customization options. Nice. Seamoth. Seamoth may be modified by installing upgrade modules. These modules may be manufactured in an appropriately outfitted moon pool. Yeah, okay, so cool. Things and stuff. Do I have, hang on, while I'm up here and just breathing normally, do I have miscellaneous lab counter trash cans? Everything's made of titanium. I have the vehicle modification station, which will be nice when I have the moon pool, which I don't have yet. I need to find that. That is the thing I need to find. Let's go back down here while we've still got daylight. And look around for anything else interesting and not get eaten by Chompy McChomperson over there. I'm actually really excited about this game. Like, there's so much more to do in it with this update because you can find things so much more easily. And I'm really, really pleased about that. I didn't need that titanium, but I took it anyway. And I'm really, really pleased about that because I couldn't find anything and everything was scattered. And if I missed one thing, please go away. Please go away. I don't really want to dangle with you right now. Jeez, go away. That looks like something I can scan in or pick up. And it sure is. Oh, mobile vehicle bay fragment, yes! Is that it? Did I do it? Go away. How? Go fuck yourself. Jeez, I hate you. Fine, I will cut you. I'm done playing around. I'm gonna shank you guys. Go away. Gosh. I don't have the sea moth yet. I don't have all the sea moth yet. But do I have the, what is that? Pressure compensator. Oh, a bunch of other stuff. Okay. Hull reinforcement. These are all, sea moth things. Mobile vehicle bay. Yes! Titanium ingot lubricant power cell. I already have the power cell. We can make lubricant. Oh, good things are happening. I still need to find more fragments of the sea moth. I'm gonna see if there's another fragment around here or not. And then I'm going to piece the fuck out of this place because these goddamn, sand sharks are all up on my face. Oh, what the hell is that? It is stuck in there. You poor thing. What are you? A bioreactor fragment. You are bioreacting, all right. Let's put you out of your misery, jeez. Oh, I think that was it. Was that it? I think that was it. Yeah, that was all I needed for the blueprint. Excellent, let's get out of here. Cool, that was fun. Glad I didn't miss that. I don't need it yet because I don't have the multi-purpose room yet, but that's okay. Oh my god, these... Oh god. You know what? I'm just leaving. I'm leaving. I need health. I'll come back here later sometime. And I think that's all I can get from here. Okay, he's just doing his own thing in the sand. That's fine with me. Jeez, get out of here! Why me? Why this? Alright, you know what? This episode, I've been recording for an hour and a half straight. My voice is getting tired, so I'm gonna show you guys one last thing I wanna do to get you really hyped up for the next installment of this series, and that is I'm gonna show you guys what's behind this mist over here. So it's gonna take a while to get to it, but it's gonna be worth the wait. I'm not gonna show you the whole thing, obviously I'm gonna cut through it, but this little cloud over here is hiding something very, very interesting that I haven't seen before, and I haven't really, explored much, and I'm super excited about it. That was as far as I'd gotten in, my playthrough on my own. I played it on my own a little bit with this, no food, no water game that I played before. So I'm super excited to show this to you. I know you can tell by the sound of my voice. I'm super excited, right? So excited. And I will see you guys there in a second, and that'll be the end of the episode. We're going to hype up the next installment of this series. And that'll be it, I think. Yay! Oh, that looks interesting. Oh, I saw it. Did you guys see it? Oh man, what is it? Whoa! Holy shit! Look at it! Ooh, look at it! Oh. It's a mountain. It's a huge fucking island is what it is. It's kind of chilling in the mist here. Right off the coast of, the Aurora. Look at this shit. That's hiding in the mist. I'm pretty sure there's another one, like, over... there-ish, I guess, maybe? I'm not super sure, but anyway, check this shit out. Look at it. It's so neat. But there's more to it than just a rock, I promise. This is the thing I haven't fully explored yet. I have no idea. Oh, check it out. It just phased into existence over there. I have no idea what this thing is, but I am super excited to find out. It is currently floating in the air. It hasn't finished loading yet, I think. Anyway, that is going to be, you know, that's going to be it. That's going to be a little teaser for this episode. Oh god, it's so big. Anyway, that's going to do it for this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. I have been Sevenery. This has been Subnautica. And in the next episode, we're actually not going to deal with this thing. We are going to find the sea moth and, I don't know, build up our base and try to get into the Aurora. And then we will deal with whatever the hell this is when it comes naturally to us. I will see you guys next time. Take care.